Did you know that I made a ToDoIst course? No, but like, did you know? You, the one watching right now. Because I made a ToDoIst course, and if you want to go check it out on Skillshare and or buy it off of my Gumroad, then make sure to go into the link down below to make that happen. Because in that course, you're going to get more content just like this, but you can go from beginner to pro rather than just learning one part of it. But in this video, I want to talk about filters and how you can make them work for you. So in this fancy tab right here, if you press G and then V from anywhere, when you're in ToDoIst, you will navigate to the filters and label page. And here you'll be able to do something that essentially creates custom views for you. Now, something important to point out that's different between things like filters and projects is the fact that you cannot change these into board views. So if you see here, if I press Shift V, it'll go back and forth between board view and list view. You cannot do that. You cannot do that in filters, but what you can do is set things up to filter to your liking. So this is a very advanced filter that I have set up, which says today or overdue, and it is from the project work and is not a priority four task. So essentially this says important work from today because this exclamation point gets rid of anything that you put past it. Now there is a bit of an order of operations style to this query, and I will show you some more examples right here. So if I wanted to make a new filter and just have it be the basic stuff, this is work tasks. You can have hashtag work. And if I press this add one, this work task will bring in all of the work stuff. So that's layer one. Now layer two could be work tasks that are today or tomorrow. So what we could do here is put a parenthesis to combine a query and have today and then this parallel line here, today or tomorrow, and then you can put and as a work task. So there are no tasks that are either today or tomorrow and a work task. So if I go here and make this guy today and this guy tomorrow, we go back to these filters to work tasks. You'll see that it brought up today and tomorrow. If we want to favorite a filter like this, we can go to the three dots here and press add to favorites. Or if when we're in here, we can also just press this right here. Say we had different sub projects within this and we only wanted to have a sub project that was within it. So let's say I copy this work one and just name this reports and write one that says report example one at 5 p.m. today. If we go to work tasks, you'll see that this doesn't show up in here. But if we go to filters and labels again, or go to the top right here and press edit filter, what we can do is we can put a second hashtag and that will get all of the sub projects underneath work as well, because now it adds this report right here. So a double hashtag will add anything specifically from these reports since it has all of the sub projects below it. If I duplicate this guy again, it creates another report example because this is a copy of reports, and then I can put meetings here and I'm gonna put this meeting example tomorrow. Then if we go back to the work task section, we'll see there's a meeting example tomorrow. But what if I wanted to exclude meetings? I could put today or tomorrow and work. Then I could put another and not meetings. And you'll see it removed that. If I undid this, it would show the meetings again. So another way we can do this with the and not situation and only having specific things is if I added some labels to this. So I put like an at root task, and made this a project task, and then made this a meeting for the label. We can do the exact same situation here where if we went to the edit filters, we can make it and not at, since add is the label query, and we can put meeting. So that removed anything that had the tag that is not, that removed, it removed anything with the tag, it removed anything with the label on it that had meeting. I could also combine multiple different projects here. So if I put work and side hustle tasks, I can put this as well, where I would change it from work and rise productive with a double hashtag to get all of the specific ones under here. If I went here and changed it specifically to work or rise productive, that would bring both of these together. So say I added a task from here to today and another one for tomorrow and change these parentheses to combine them together. Then it would separate these two. A key mistake I just made actually is I had to add a space here. When I add a space here, it then brings those in. So that's how you can have multiple different projects show. And you can do this infinitely with this symbol. So I could do the growth one again, as there is a workout today. And I can put another and. It's not a P4. Then it would exclude anything that's not a priority four. So as you can see, only important stuff stayed there. You can mix and match pretty much anything that you have in your ToDoIst workflow with filters if you know what you're doing. And hopefully this video will also help you improve what you're doing with your productivity.